Hi, my name is Harshal Kumar. I'm a National Renewable Energy Fellow from Ministry of New and Renewable Energy and founder CEO of a startup OnPro Signatory. I'm working on a project which is integration of artificial intelligence, big data analytics and Internet of Things architecture into smart farming and meticulous examination of the impact on crop economics. So currently, as you can see, the Indian agriculture is facing tremendous pressure to increase crop production to meet consumer demand for food. In coherence with the United Nations Food and Agriculture Organization, food production must increase by more than 60% in order to meet consumer demand, which is going to be around 6 billion. So increasing crop production is the cornerstone solution of any problem, deciphering food shortage or profitability problem. Of course, this IoT, AI and big data analytics architecture will bring about more proactive decision making, more accurate outcome prediction and faster problem diagnosis. The entire world smart agriculture market is expected to grow by to around $18.45 billion at the annual cumulative growth of around 12.45. As per Business Insider report, more than 75 million IoT devices would be exported by 2020 at a CAGR rate of around 12%. In India, the agriculture sector is still using traditional methods which is not effective in current time. And this architecture has been used into another domains, but in agriculture in India, there has been no work done so far. So what positive outcomes we have achieved yet? We are finding that we have been able to do or execute effective management of water resources with no water wasted, effective weed management, unremitting monitoring of the land so that precaution could be taken at an early stage, and profiting the farmer basically so that he can take a right decision for planting his seeds on the basis of his soil, his climate and different other factors. So BRICS platform has really helped us in collaborating on different projects and gaining valuable insight that what is happening in their country and how we can have a mutual exchange of views, ideas and technologies with which we can benefit each other. This is absolutely which is science and diplomacy.